A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem, Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem. My respected brothers and my sisters, today I'm going to talk to you about a very important subject, and that is anger, confrontation. You know, this is a problem that we all sometime get involved. Today I'm going to give you a few tips how can we avoid getting in confrontation with anybody. How I can control my anger. What exactly happens when I am angry in response to somebody else's anger? There was a scholar in India. You know, these are some examples I'm going to give you just for personification. If you can personify, you know, these examples, and you can keep them in your mind when such situation comes up, so that way you can hold yourself that you do not want to go that low. These examples are just to give us some imagination and some ideas that how we can control our anger and confrontation. Remember one fact: when you are angry, at that time your emotional brain and your intellect brain, they both get disconnected. So when you are angry or somebody is angry, he will not understand any logic, any argument at that point. Second, always remember, when you get angry, actually you are hurting yourself. Whenever we get angry, as a doctor, I can tell you that our hormones, our body, the whole body gets disturbed. Our emotions, our feelings, our mind, everything gets affected. And it takes many hours to whole body to settle down again. There was a scholar in India, Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan. He has written one article about arguments and confrontation. He says, imagine two dogs, they are fighting on a street. How they behave with each other. One trying to attack, the other one is trying to attack. One is barking, other one is barking in response. And imagine that whole scene when two dogs are fighting, confronting each other. My brothers and my sisters, when two people get angry and they get, you know, in confrontation with each other, exactly we go that low like animals. Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayh has given one example in his book Ahya al-Ulum. Through personification, and when we personify these examples, he says, imagine there are four things sitting in your heart: one dog, one pig, shaitan, and angel. Whenever you are angry, you are in confrontation with somebody, and you are arguing with somebody, somebody is getting out of control, to have this imagination, this is the work like a dog. If somebody is showing indecency and he is filthy, that's the quality of pig. And he says, if somebody is showing arrogance, takabbur, belittling other people, thinking of himself that he is somebody bigger and higher and above everybody, these are the qualities of shaitan. But if angel inside dominates your personality, then you are loving person, you are caring person, you are soft, you are gentle, you want to stay connected. These are the qualities of angel. My brothers and my sisters, I also want to remind you here few ahadith. One time, if you remember, there was argument between Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and somebody else, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was present at that time. And as long as the other person was insulting Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and Hazrat Abu Bakr was quiet, he was not responding, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was kept smiling and standing there. But as soon as Hazrat Abu Bakr started responding to that person, Prophet ﷺ got angry and left. And Hazrat Abu Bakr went to Prophet ﷺ and asked, Ya Rasulullah, didn't you see that how that person was behaving and insulting me? Look at the response of the Prophet ﷺ. Prophet ﷺ said, Abu Bakr, as long as you were quiet, there was angel who was responding on your behalf. But when you started responding, then angel left and shaitan came And you know, wherever there is shaitan, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam cannot stand at that place. There was another hadith of the Prophet in which he said, the real wrestler is not the one who can defeat his opponent, but real strong person, the wrestler is the one, if he is angry, he can control his anger. One time Buddha was asked, you know, somebody came to Buddha and insulted him with very foul language, and Buddha stayed quiet. And after that person left, some people asked Buddha how you didn't respond to him. Buddha said, you know, if somebody brings any gift to you and if you don't accept that gift stays with who? People say the one who brought the gift. He said the very same way, if he brought this foul language, whatever he was, his anger, if I do not accept that, that is going to stay with the person who came with anger and foul language. There is another, you know, story I want to share with you, because in our families we see, you know, arguments and confrontation quite often. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, when he was standing on janaza of his wife, and he said that I was married to this woman for 42 years, but we never had any argument. And after the janaza, some people asked Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, how is it possible that you were married for 42 years and there was no argument? His reply was that whenever she was angry, I stay, you know, quiet at that time. And when I was angry, she did not respond and she stayed quiet. The best way to control your anger is that try to stay with wudu. Try to change the situation. If your sense of humor is good, then maybe you can throw a joke at that time, or try to divert that discussion to some other direction. Change your position. Leave the room. If you can take break for a few seconds, then whole situation can get changed. Some people suggest if you have tasbih in your hand, that tasbih that you are in zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that can also keep shaitan away from you, my brothers and my sisters. And another suggestion in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that if you are standing, sit down. If you are sitting, lay down, or drink few sips of water, or go and make wudu, or leave the place. When such situation comes, if we can bring these imaginations, and if we can personify what examples I have given you, if you see a video of people who are fighting with each other, who are arguing with each other, and they are in hot exchange with each other, wallahi, they look like exactly what two dogs when they are fighting on a street, they do. We don't want to go that low. We don't want to follow that path. That we really should keep our dignity, our waqar, our honor. This is in our hand. We really should feel sorry for him. And the way he is behaving, that's not a human way to behave. I know sometimes anger is good, but in most of the cases, anger damages your own personality, your own image. If there are people sitting and somebody comes and insults you, if you really feel secure in that domain of your life, people who will be there, they will witness that the person who is angry, actually he is losing his status. He is losing his dignity. He is losing his waqar. He is losing his position. And people will still appreciate your response, because as a Muslim, we all have to learn that we should respond, not react. And reaction is uncalculated, unthought, abrupt reaction we show. Abruptly, whatever comes out of our tongue. But response is well thought after you have measured all the effects of something. So I will say that as a Muslim, we should respond, not react, and keep these examples I have given you of Buddha, Sir Sayyid Ahmad, Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayh, and the ahadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the story of Hazrat Abu Bakr and that angry man. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us that we can keep our anger in control, and we can show when there is argument or when there is any confrontation, we show our dignity, our waqar, and the civilized way of arguments and confrontation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help all of us. Jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah.